I'm extremely bowled over by the kind of amazing minds, extraordinary minds gathered here. A huge round of applause to all you wonderful people here. Especially the panel discussion, the members who were here. I'm so amazed. And by making your clap also, I'm trying to get you a lot of sleep. So yes, it's a matter of great honor and privilege for me to be here amongst you all in IIT. Amongst you, the elite group of engineers present here in this institution of excellence. If not medicine, probably I would have been one amongst you all as a proud IITian. And yes, for maybe in the organizers, you guys belong to an age group of like 18 to 23, 22, 23? Yeah, so I'm a student myself. And what makes me stand here is those little bit of achievements that I've made in my life. And I wish I could show you that all of them in my documentary, but since because of the technical trouble, we couldn't do that. But you can always Google, I mean, YouTube my name, Tejaswini Manogna, you can find my documentary and everything there, available there. I always believed in this principle of Swayam Tejaswim Bhava, which means shine by yourself. Shine for yourself and do spread the light to others. In my view, entrepreneurship is all about creating opportunities not just for yourself but to people around you. Education is much more than employment, it's more about enlightenment. And the word entrepreneurship, I think, emphasizes on the life stories of eminent personalities like, you know, Steve Jobs and recently Manohar Parikar. Like, if you've heard what they told in their last stages of their life, they said, you know, that it's not earning is not everything, or earning is not the primary objective of your life. And I might not be as great as them, like I am just a drop in an ocean out of all the works that they have done, but here's my life story for all of y'all. I'm Dr. Tejaswini Manogna, a young Indian with many passions. Apart from being a medical doctor, I'm a professionally qualified Bharatanatyam artist, singer, yoga practitioner, motivational speaker, sportsperson, social activist, and a social entrepreneur. I'm a girl who became an achiever against all the odds, like discriminations, rejections. I broke stereotypes, carved my way to success in unconventional fields, going an extra mile to pursue my dreams. My journey from performing on stage to the Army NCC grounds, to the hospitals, to the ramp, has been very educative. Okay, at a naughty age of 3 or 4, my mom never used to let me sleep for longer hours. She made sure that I woke up early in the morning just to instill some sense of discipline in my life. And I still follow the same principle. I still compete with the sun every day in the morning, and I win the race every day by waking up before the sun. And yes, she showed me newspaper articles of eminent personalities and their contributions that they have done for the nation. But what fascinated me is those huge trophies they had in their hands. And she got me initiated into elocution, into a lot of activities. I saw myself winning small prizes, you know, medals and certifications, which inspired me to do more. And I felt I was being happy doing all of that. And she took me to every nook and corner of the city. And at a stage, she actually gave up her job when she was working in US for a year. And then we've seen the society, I mean, the society had an eye of criticism on both of us. But I've seen how strong she stood for me. And then I learned the qualities of being able to face challenges from her. And of course, those little excitements of seeing myself in the newspapers, cutting my articles later, and celebrating every small achievement that I made had made a huge difference in my life. And also, she never used to let me play for longer hours. She taught me how to balance my play hour, my study hour, my dance classes, and my sleep time. And that's how, ladies and gentlemen, I learned to balance in my life. So I learned the qualities of balance and time management. And these are the qualities which I imbibe from my parents. And I think empowerment for every child starts at home itself. And I'm extremely thankful for them for giving me the unlimited opportunities to explore myself. I became a social entrepreneur at an age when I didn't know what it meant. At an age of 7 or 8, I actually wanted to contribute to one of those child who was suffering from an illness. I could not donate any money to her, but then I decided to perform for an NGO. And spontaneously from one of the audience, like one of them gave me 5,000 rupees spontaneously, and that was my first earning ever. And I wanted to donate the same for the cause. And I always have the courage to take on the mic and tell the people that not to encourage child labor. So my journey into all of this started right back then itself, and now I realize that I was a social entrepreneur then. And I had a passion for nation building. I had a fascination for the army uniform. For a girl at ninth class, I used to believe that I can be a substitute in case of national emergency, and that's how I joined NCC. I found my path to Republic Day camp, and right before going to the national camp, I was rejected. As a child, I was really broken because I worked very hard for six months. But then, success is not about winning, but about picking up yourself yet another time and moving ahead. And with my dedication and disciplined efforts, I worked hard for 18 hours a day with early morning rifle drills at 4 a.m., rifle shooting, group discussions, extempores, and 12 a.m. studying. And with all of that, with a consistent and disciplined effort, I became the All India's best cadet in NCC among 13 lakh cadets, and I received the Prime Minister's Medal and President's Appreciation Medal. I heard this quote, which says, अपने हौसलों को ये मत बताओ कि तुम्हारे तकलीफ कितना बड़ा है, अपने तकलीफ को बता दो कि तुम्हारा हौसला कितना बड़ा है। My Hindi might be bad, but I really like the quote. Let difficulties know that you too are difficult. While I was experiencing this most glorious moment of my life, I'm sure most of y'all, 90% of y'all will be from corporate institutions, Sri Chaitanya Narayana, we must have undergone all the star patches and all those things, right? So, yes. So while I was experiencing the most glorious moment of my life, while I got the Prime Minister's honor, on the other hand, I was removed from my star badge because they thought I wouldn't be able to achieve my goals if I concentrate on both of the things. And then my mom was extremely disturbed. With my grit and determination, my whole of second year of intermediate, I sat at home. I made myself preparation and I secured a seat in Usmania Medical College. And I felt like I built a castle out of all the stones that were thrown at us at that moment. And throughout medical schooling, as soon as I got into medical schooling, my professors initially told me that you are into medicine, now enough with your activities. But can life, career, passion, profession be an either or option? I think the trick is balance. If you know how to balance yourself, how to balance between what you want to do and what you need to do, you can achieve anything that is placed in front of you. I navigated through my schedules and I managed to participate in a few national and international competitions, and I bagged the titles of Telugammai, a traditional pain and beauty contest it was, and then I was the student of the year for Southern India, I got the Youth Icon Award and a Women Achiever Award in Dubai and Science Congress in London and US. So, yes, while doing all this, yet I managed to graduate from medicine with distinction. So that was what made me unique, that I could balance both my passion and my profession. And soon after college, I wanted to give myself a chance to explore myself into new avenues. And that's how I went to the competition of Miss Universe India, where without knowing anything, I just found my path towards it and I went for it and I managed to become the Miss Talented Miss Universe India. I was the top five of that contest. I was really close to making my dream come true of winning the crown. But as you all know, reality has other colors. When it comes to people management, not everything is a fair deal. The reason why I wanted to go to this contest is that I had a vision that I wanted to represent my country in international organization as an ambassador, like be it UN, WHO, UNESCO. But anything, you know, for that matter, any obstacles and challenges that I might have to overcome to make my country proud, I will still do that. And as I kept saying, reality has other colors, right? How do you think I funded myself doing so much? I'm not born in any rich family. Okay, so the reality, you know, the costumes, the jewelry, the makeup, the transport, the orchestra, publicity, everything had a huge, you know, huge cost, and the expenditure was way too much than what I could demand as a young artist. And belonging to a middle class family, we still don't have an own house. My mom, she actually gave up her job. And as you know, medical students, they start earning late in their life. I really didn't want to depend on my parents for just to fund my passion. And frankly, friends, like after 23 and 24, once you're out of college, there'll be a lot of pressure on you for job and, you know, to make your own earning. And that's the stage where you really don't want to depend on your parents. Passion saves you during times of crisis. And passion gives you that pathway to come out of your setbacks. Passion equals talent equals energy equals excellence equals life. And in this professional journey that you are, we somewhere tend to forget our passions. And the passion is something which makes you unique, completely unique, and each one of you is rare and one of a kind. In my childhood, my mom used to carry me. She used to take me to dance classes. We used to change from one bus stop to the other, change three buses, carry loads of luggage, and then walk a lot of distance in sun and rain. And by the time I used to reach my classes, I always used to see my friends who used to luxuriously come in cars. Of course, they were good people. They always offered me lift for half a distance. But the thing is, like, I used to ask my mom if we would ever buy a car. And then she told me, you put in your efforts and one day you will definitely win a car. And exactly when I turned 18, I participated in a traditional brain and beauty contest, which is Telugammai. And to my surprise, I was gifted a Tata Nano car. I know Sir has spoken a lot about Tata Nano car right now, but I loved traveling in that car. It's a very small car, but I love it. And later on, I was gifted a laptop, and for being the Miss Talented, I was gifted a Yamaha Fasino bike, and I got a free seat into Osmania Medical College. So what else does a student need at that age? In a way, I was actually reducing the burden on my financial burden on my parents. Guys, it's not about having a car or bank balance or anything. It is about those moments when your efforts have seen fruits, when you succeed after putting, a maximum of your efforts when you work beyond your limit. And soon I became one of those trending names in the regional institutions where I got to interact with a lot of thousands of students like y'all, where I got to share my story, where I got to learn from the students. And in the same process, one of those institutions has actually recognized me and offered me to establish an Academy of Excellence on my name. And that soon is going to become a reality. So balance have a ripple effect not on yourself, but the entire world around you. I gave courage and inspiration to many others along my way, genuinely working as a doctor and a socially responsible person towards various causes associated with children. I remember a life member of an organization called TEACHER, which means Team for Enlightened Action for Child Health, Education and Rehabilitation. I've been visiting government schools, government colleges, and a lot of institutions like that, and trying to motivate the people there. Also, construction of toilets and prevention of childhood blindness and against child labor. So I've been working towards various causes like that. And life is interdisciplinary. I don't really look up to myself because of the achievements, but I look up to myself for the values I imbibed in myself from all the achievements that I've made. Dancing gave me the confidence to stand on the stage, and yoga gave me a flexible body and concentration, which helped me in my studies. And so all of these, singing, fine-tuned me as a human being. Being in army, it gave me discipline and dedication. So it is these qualities which is making me stand here today amongst y'all. And as I said, life. And guys, winning is not in itself success. Successful people need not be winners, and winners need not be successful all the time. So just being happy in itself means being successful. Being able to follow your instincts and develop on yourself means success. And entrepreneurship for me is way beyond earning money and showing ways of earning money to others. Enjoy your journey, and your destiny will come to you automatically. And I'm lucky enough to have my parents, who've always channelized my energies in the right direction, who told me, you are in the chase of your profession and passion, but what stays with you forever is your personality. You will be remembered for that. Give back to your nation in whatever way you can. And this talk today in IIT, I consider it as yet another milestone in my life. I say it a milestone because a milestone never shows the distance that you've already traveled. It shows the distance that is to be traveled, and I learned to myself the achievements that I still have to make for myself and my nation today. Thank you so much.